It's my pleasure right now to introduce to you the Reverend Broken Oliver, pastor of Open Door Baptist Church. He has so graciously consented to provide us with a program of music tonight, he and his whole family. And right now I want to turn the program over to Pastor Oliver.
God bless you. Thank you. Well, here we are. And soon we'll be there, wherever that is. But I know it's in the presence of the Lord. Here we are in God's presence. Let this be your worship tonight.
Here we are in your presence, lifting holy hands to you. Here we are praising Jesus for the things he's brought us through. I don't have the words to tell you how I feel. I just don't know why I can say. I'm not so worthy to speak your holy name, yet you tell me you love me just the same. In your presence, lifting holy hands to you. Here we are. Here we are. Praising Jesus. Praising Jesus for the things he's brought us through. I never thought that it could be this way, and I never thought that I would be the same. But Lord, you found me dying in my sin, and you looked at me and loved me, then took me in.
If you're in, sing it.
Here we are
praising Jesus.
Lifting holy hands to you. Yes, here we are praising Jesus for the things he's brought us.
Every one of them.
For the things he's brought us through. Thank you, Jesus.
Let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we openly confess that the Word of God will come forth boldly and accurately during this meeting and during this gathering, and that the people who hear your Word will not be able to resist the wisdom and the inspiration of the Holy Spirit that will be spoken through your ministers of the gospel. We confess that as your Word comes forth in song and in speech, an anointing of the Holy Spirit will cause people to open their spiritual eyes and ears and turn from darkness to light, from the power of Satan to you, God, and make Jesus their Lord. We commit this blessing and this meeting to you, Father. We deposit it into your charge, entrusting this gathering, the people who will hear and the people who will speak into your protection and care. We commend this gathering to the Word, the commands and counsels and promises of your unmerited favor. Father, we know your Word will build up the people and cause them to realize that they are joint heirs with Jesus. We believe, Father, that as your Word comes forth, an anointing will be upon the singers, the speakers, and all those involved, and they will be submitted completely to the Holy Spirit, for the Word of God that is spoken is alive and full of power, making it active, operative, energizing, and effective, being sharper than any two-edged sword. We believe that every need of every person will be met spiritually, physically, mentally, and financially. We thank you, Father, and praise you that because we have asked and agreed together, these petitions have come to pass. Let these words with which we have made supplication before you, Lord, be near to the Lord our God day and night, that he may maintain the cause and right of his people and the gathering as each day of it requires. We believe that all the earth's people will know that the Lord is God and there is no other. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Well, we're here to worship the Lord, and I trust that you're expecting a blessing. Put your cups out right now. Put them out. Come on. You know, we do this occasionally at the Baptist church. You might get surprised. Put your cups out and ask the Lord to fill it up, overflowing, okay? Ask him. Ask him right now. Amen. Now, the Lord wants to take our lives, as we see in this song, and to break us and pour us out, even as Jesus was broken and spilled out for us. Broken and spilled out.
One day a plain village woman, driven by love for her Lord, recklessly poured out a valuable essence, disregarding the score. And once it was broken and spilled out, a fragrance filled all the room. Like a prisoner released from his shackles, like a spirit set free from the tomb, broken and spilled out. Just for love of you, Jesus, my most precious treasure, lavished on thee, broken and spilled out, and poured out. Thank you. up and done. Lord, let me be spilled out and used up for Thee. Lord, You are God's most precious treasure, His only beloved Son, sent here to show us the way to the Father, just for His love it was done. And though You were perfect and holy, You gave up Your life willingly. You spared no expense for my pardon. You were used up and wasted for me. Just for love of me, Jesus, God's most wondrous treasure, lavished on me. In sweet abandon, Lord, You were spilled out and used up for me. Let me be spilled out in sweet abandon.
Praise the Lord. Karen will come and sing. This is my darling wife and mother of my five children, four that you will see tonight and one that you will see in August or whenever it gets here. But you know, that child is already here. We've heard the heartbeat. We've seen even a picture of sorts. And we'll take the child that the Lord brings forth. And Karen, sing for us.
You know I want to see Jesus, because he's the one who died for us all. Then I bowed on my knees and cried, holy, holy, holy. Then I clapped my hands and sang glory, glory to the Son of God. As I entered the city, my loved ones, you know, they all knew me well. They all showed me through the streets of heaven. Scenes, they're just too numerous to tell. I saw Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Oh, I saw Mark, Luke, Paul, and Timothy.
You know, we didn't know anything about abortion and all those problems when we got married, and we didn't understand all the difficulties of growing up in the world. But when we found out that Karen was going to have our first child, then the Lord put it in our heart to pray for her in the womb every day. We prayed for her. We talked to her in the womb. We sang to her in the womb. And we did it because we loved her. When we first found out that she was there inside my wife's womb, we loved her. We've loved her all these 11 years, 11 and a half years, right? And we gave her to the Lord when we first found out that she was conceived. She's not our child. She belongs to the Lord in heaven, and we just are stewards of her. And that's the way we feel that parents should be. For the Bible says children are the heritage of the Lord. That's our inheritance, our reward. And so, therefore, she belongs to her Father in heaven. And Catherine Elizabeth is going to come and sing about her father's eyes. Bring up the boys, and that's what we have here, the boys, and they're going to come up and sing a song. We can get them a chair here, Mom, and we'll get them all set up. We're talking about family tonight, if you haven't caught on. Everything we're singing about is a relationship with God.